The dean, if we believe report, was never ill-received at court. As for his works in verse and prose, I own myself no judge of those. Nor can I tell what critics thought 'em, but this I know, all people bought 'em. As with a moral view designed to cure the vices of mankind, his vein, ironically grave, exposed the fool and lashed the knave. To steal a hint was never known, but what he writ was all his own. He never thought an honor done him, because a duke was proud to own him, would rather slip aside and choose to talk with wits in dirty shoes. Despised the fools with stars and garters, so often seen caressing charters. He never courted men in station, nor persons had in admiration. Of no man's greatness was afraid, because he sought for no man's aid. Though trusted long in great affairs, he gave himself no haughty airs. Without regarding private ends, spent all his credit for his friends, and only chose the wise and good, no flatterers, no allies in blood, but succored virtue in distress, and seldom failed of good success, as numbers in their hearts must own, who but for him had been unknown. Had he but spared his tongue and pen, he might have rose like other men. But power was never in his thought, and wealth he valued not a groat. Ingratitude he often found, and pitied those who meant the wound. But kept the tenor of his mind to merit well of humankind, nor made a sacrifice of those who still were true to please his foes. He labored many a fruitless hour to reconcile his friends in power, saw mischief by a faction brewing while they pursued each other's ruin. But finding vain was all his care, he left the court in mere despair. Perhaps I may allow the dean had too much satire in his vein, and seemed determined not to starve it, because no age could more deserve it. Yet malice never was his aim. He lashed the vice, but spared the name. No individual could resent where thousands equally were meant. His satire points at no defect, but what all mortals may correct. For he abhorred that senseless tribe who call it humor when they jibe. He spared a hump or crooked nose whose owners set not up for bows. True, genuine dullness moved his pity, unless it offered to be witty. Those who their ignorance confessed, he ne'er offended with a jest, but laughed to hear an idiot quote a verse from Horace learned by rote. He knew 100 pleasant stories with all the turns of Whigs and Tories, was cheerful to his dying day, and friends would let him have his way. He gave the little wealth he had to build a house for fools and mad, and showed by one satiric touch no nation wanted it so much. That kingdom he hath left his debtor. I wish it soon may have a better.